hemangioendotheliomas. Hemangioendotheliomas comprise heterogeneous group of borderline vascular neoplasms with an intermediate biological behavior. So when we say we have an intermediate biological behavior, the behavior of these neoplasms actually fall between benign, that is well-differentiated hemangiomas, and aggressively malignant angiosarcomas. So they fall between these two categories. That is the reason we are calling it as borderline vascular neoplasm, fall between the benign as well as the most aggressive malignant ones. And here we have three important subtypes what we identified in hemangioendothelioma. The first one is the epithelioid hemangioendotheliomas, which are more aggressive. And second type is the pseudomyogenic, which again between aggressive and less aggressive. So we can say it has an intermediate behavior in the category of hemangioendothelioma. And third one is called as a hobnail pattern. So hobnail pattern or hobnail type of hemangioendotheliomas are less aggressive. So epithelioid, more aggressive, hobnail, less aggressive. These are the two important MCQs what you need to know about hemangioendothelioma. So let us talk about the first one, which is called as epithelioid hemangioendothelioma. So more often we can see this epithelioid type in males, but there is no much difference between the male and female ratio, and they can occur at any age, but remember that rare in the childhood. So that's the reason majority of the authors are not describing the male-female ratio, but the latest studies says that it is more often seen in males when compared to females. And these neoplasms often presents as painful subcutaneous mass, which are either superficial or deeper. And lung, liver and bone may also be the primary site in epithelioid type. And approximately 50% are associated with the blood vessels. That is the reason we are calling it as hemangioendotheliomas. Most commonly, these are seen in association with medium to large sized veins, which leads to venous occlusion with a resultant edema or thrombophlebitis because of the involvement of the medium to large size veins. So the clinical course of this particular type is highly variable. Even though the excision is a curative in vast majority of the cases, but approximately 40% of the tumors can recur and 20% to 30% eventually metastasize, and 15% or less than that of the patient die because of their tumors. So this is the first type called as epithelioid type. Next, let us talk about pseudomyogenic hemangioendothelioma, which is the second one. So which falls between the most severe as well as less severe one. It has an intermediate behavior. So it is also known as epithelioid sarcoma-like hemangioendothelioma. But this one most commonly affects males, which means we can clearly predict male-female ratio, that is 4:1, and more often seen in younger to middle-aged individuals with a very peak incidence at 30 years of age. So they generally fall between 25 to 40 years of age with a peak incidence of 30 years of age, and male to female ratio is 4:1, so it has a high gender predominance towards males. So classically, the pseudomyogenic type of hemangioendothelioma presents as a dermal or subcutaneous nodules on extremities rather than deeper structures, but most often they involve the lower limb subcutaneous areas. And these lesions, or we can say these neoplasms, they occasionally ulcerate, and as the progression of the disease, multiple tumor nodules develop in that area. They cluster together in the same area where they develop, and in vast majority of the cases they present with multifocal lesions, right? So depending upon number of nodules, ulceration, as well as depending on the anatomical area, we can identify the severity of this particular neoplasm. and the local recurrence after excision occur in around approximately 50% of the cases, but in such condition, metastasization of these neoplasms are very rare. And what will be the time of excision? So the time of excision to local recurrence is generally 1 to 2 years, and remember that this tumor is not generally fatal. And next one is the last one, hobnail type of hemangioendothelioma, and it is the most important one for your exam. So hobnail type of hemangioendothelioma refers to closely related tumors. One is the retiform and another one is the Dabska type. So retiform as well as Dabska type of hemangioendothelioma often associated with the hobnail pattern, which both containing the cuboidal endothelial cells with a very high nuclear as well as cytoplasmic ratio. That's the reason this is classified under two subcategories. So these related tumors generally share overlapping features, although they affect different demographics. For example, if you see the Dabska type of hemangioendothelioma, which often seen in the children, while the retiform subtype is often seen in the adults where the mean age is 40. So by age distribution, we can easily identify whether it is Dabska pattern or we can say it is retiform one. So both of these things can develop plaques, which often poorly circumscribed with an overlying violaceous hue, right? So these hobnail pattern of hemangioendotheliomas tend to be very low grade neoplasms, which means very less progressive in nature, or not at all aggressive when compared to that of other two types in the category. But although they have certain potential to extend to the regional lymph nodes, in such condition they may be catastrophic in nature. So all these are the types of hemangioendotheliomas.